Welcome, welcome, welcome. My name is Nirav Shah. I'm the Principal Product Manager for AWS's Elemental Media Live live transcoding service. And thank you for joining me here today. I'm going to quickly walk you through what is Elemental Media Live, the 101 version. Think about college and that 101 course. I'm going to give you a quick crash course of what Media Live is and why it's important. I'm going to take you through a couple features that we've launched, highlight a few areas of importance, walk you through what's the difference between a standard channel and a single pipeline channel, and really what's coming up in terms of how we're improving some of the playout functionality that we've established inside of Media Live. So thank you for joining, and hope you enjoy the journey. Let's start out about what is Media Live. Media Live is a live broadcasting transcoding service for doing 24/7 channels or by doing event-based programming. And what does that mean? It means you are streaming content 24/7, or you're doing spinning up small events. Think about the NCAA tournament. That's a small event that gets spun up and spun down. It basically takes inputs and outputs and creates an ABR stack that you can distribute to all your endpoint devices, and it allows you to do monetization through the SCT35 marking. So it's a soup to nuts broadcast quality service that allows you to enjoy content on all your devices downstream, whether it be an iPad, an iPhone or cell phone, or whatever your device of choice is. It's a fully managed service, so as you need it, you get it. You are able to spin up or spin down your service. You don't have to worry about what type of cloud event you need or cloud resources you need. That's all managed by AWS. And it scales to your need, and it scales down to your needs as well. It also gives you a highly resilient and redundant service that's built around two availability zones. And availability zones are different setups in one particular type of region. So if one region fails, or one availability zone fails, you have the ability to spin over into that next availability zone using our standard dual pipeline or standard channel service. As we talked about, you can pay for it on demand, or you have 24/7 pricing. It's all flexible, depending on what you as a customer really want to do. So what is Elemental Media Live? It's really the heart of AWS Media Services. And I say the heart because when you think of a person's heart, you bring in blood and you pump out blood. Well, what does Media Live do? It brings in content from multiple sources or different types of sources, packages it up, cleans it up, and actually sends it out to multiple downstream devices through a packaging delivery system, either through AWS Elemental Media Package, AWS Media Store, S3, or a third-party type of device downstream. So it's really flexible, and it's the heart of what gets your content from point A to point B on multiple types of devices. So what's happened since we launched in 2018? A lot of things have happened, and the service has grown almost 400%, and a lot of it is attributed to a couple of features I'm going to highlight here. Single pipeline is probably the biggest one that we've highlighted. It accounts for almost 50% of our overall usage model because it allows customers that are cost constrained to have a broadcast quality service in a very small price footprint. So it meets that price envelope, but gives you the scalability and flexibility that customers demand. We've simplified the output with Media Package Output Group, so you don't have to worry about different configurations. You select Media Package Output Configuration, you supply the ARN, and boom, it's configured, and you're ready to go from content coming in to a packaging service and a delivery service going out. You have the ability to lock your pipelines and to ensure that if one pipeline fails, you have the ability to move over. And that's what pipeline locking does. Seamless ability to fail over from an origin to multiple different types of content that are locked and are identical moving forward. I like to think about the vertical constraints as very interesting because it allows you to provide different types of portrait or horizontal mode or vertical distribution for bringing your content into Media Live. And the last one I'll talk about is really around encrypted HLS inputs, which allows you to really talk about privacy and bring in encrypted content into Media Live and then sending it out through an ABR stack without having to worry about it being decrypted or pilfered down the way. So those are a few of the recent releases and features from Media Live. If you want more information or more input, please feel free to email me or contact me. Or the Amazon website has a lot of great information and documentation to walk you through these individual features as well. So let's move on to what is AWS Elemental Media Live. And here I've depicted a standard channel configuration. So basically you have a single or dual source from a VPC input or a Media Connect input, and it's distributing content into two availability zones, or AZs, inside of one region. So those inputs are then configured in terms of a live channel. They're separate inputs and outputs per pipeline, and the pipelines are blocked, either through an epoch locking or another mechanism, and they're distributed from pipeline A to pipeline B, and those are ultimately distributed to a destination and then to a media AWS Elemental Media Package source for distribution, or as we talked about, a third-party source for distribution to the end devices or third-party devices. That's a standard channel. So what's the big aha in single pipeline? Well, you lose half of that, you lose that bottom box. It's basically really simple. You have a single source piece of content, again, inside that availability zone to that channel configuration, and then distributed to the AWS Elemental Media Package downstream type device. So looks simple, still has all the complexity and the sophistication of the AWS Elemental Media Live system. So you have ensured that you have good content going out to your distribution devices, but you have that small footprint, as we highlight down below, 60% cost of the dual pipeline channel. So pretty cool moving forward. So let's talk now about what's coming out, as I talked about earlier, about our playout features. So one of the big issues or problems or challenges people had when doing playout was they were limited in terms of the number of files that they could attach to a Media Live input. Well, we've solved that problem by having the number of unlimited inputs by doing a dynamic URL path. And that dynamic URL path allows you to pull in content from multiple types of sources. It can be an S3 source, an HTTP source, or a media store source. And it allows you that flexibility to have 1,000 to 100 to 2,000 types of inputs, whatever your heart's content, being able to attach into one input and being able to switch to that input using the input switch action seamlessly and on a running channel. Because one of the other issues we've had is in order to switch from one input to another, we weren't able to attach a new input to a running channel. Well, now you can. You can actually create a dynamic input and have the channel started and running and then be able to switch to a new type of input. A big boon to especially those that are doing complex playout type of applications. What's the next thing? Again, around playout is the fact that we've introduced input clipping. Input clipping allows you to basically play a file from any point in that file's location. In the past with Media Live, you could only start it from the beginning. Well, we've been able to relax that constraint. So by specifying an in time and an out time, you now have the ability to play the file from position 0, 10 minutes in, 15 minutes in, all the way to the end, or for a specific point in time. The only caveat here with input clipping is the fact that it must be from an S3 or a media store source for this particular release. The last feature I want to talk about, again, around playout, is the ability to take down. And those of you who have been in broadcast operations or seen those broadcast centers, you know, somebody goes, take now. Well, we've started to introduce that with this feature. In the past, it would take 15 to 40 seconds to basically allow you to move from file to file. Well, now with this Take Now feature, you have the ability through the console and through our API to schedule immediate action and have that file switch within the next 2 to 4 seconds. So, allows you to have that broadcast quality operation and to do seamless and robust and redundant playout types of operations. So that's a wrap up of all our new playout features. Thank you for taking the time to listen to the webcast. Hopefully you found this interesting. If it stimulated more curiosity and information for you, please reference our website. Thank you again and enjoy the rest of your day.